Welcome to King. We are actually going to start this afternoon's presentation with a video that was created by two of our juniors. So here to present their work is J.P. Lewis and Thomas Cantonacci.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm J.P. Lewis, and this is Thomas Cantonacci, and we are both juniors here at King. And just recently, we created a club called King TV, where we focus on making videos for the community, for everyone here at King to see. And over the past 2 weeks, we've been filming and putting together a video to try and tell you guys the King experience. So without further ado, please enjoy.
You're offered a lot of opportunities to pursue activities which are fitting for your respective academic river. However, whatever you do, your teachers will make you try very hard in their respective curriculums, and your fellow friends will also push you in regards to, you know, meeting deadlines and pursuing things outside of school and doing research. And I think that in many sense reflects the King community. This, you know, play hard attitude, in the sense that we all are working together to have a greater understanding of how the world works through being assertive in our academic studies.
King's very, very rigorous school. Definitely, you know, if you're not prepared to challenge yourself, you know, I don't think really King's for you. That's just my personal opinion, but, you know, it's always about meeting with teachers, and they'll help you through, and it's not impossible to do, but you know, you definitely want to be bringing your A game.
The teachers are really helpful. They're always available for extra help if you need to ask them a question, but I think that there's a mutual understanding. They expect you to come prepared if you want help from them, you know, to just showing the interest, taking the initiative. But they're always there.
Teachers are—they're very helpful. They're available to me anytime after school. If I don't understand something, they'll give me more examples to understand it, and they help me grow as a student.
Like it's impressive how much work they give us, kind of to an extent. But what doesn't make it that hard is that you can always get a huge amount of individual support from like every teacher. They're always open. They tell you when their frees are. So I mean, the work itself is hard, but getting it done isn't that difficult at all, because you've got a huge amount of support, like always.
I've always taken part in the arts. I love the theater here. We just got a new performing arts center, and it's amazing. And I was in Our Town and Hairspray and The Miser, and right now we're doing The Burial at Thebes. And like, even for plays like Burial at Thebes, which is Antigone, it's hard to perform something with such dense language. Our director helps us to say the lines right and to actually feel the characters, and I feel like I've grown a connection to my character rather than just standing on stage and spewing my lines. So I think that's what's great about the Performing Arts Center.
Do choir at King, and I'm going to do the play, the musical, But yeah, choir is run by Miss Martino, and it's basically 80 kids in the class, and we do many different songs that are multicultural from different countries in different languages.
The new PAC is incredible. The first year we had it, we did Little Shop of Horrors, and I played the dentist, and I was just a freshman, and I met so many seniors and so many new, like, really cool people. It really helps me, like, get into the social environment of the high school.
I've been here for 12 years, so I have seen the arts go through every single change. I've been to the plays here since I was in first grade. I've been seeing all the plays here, and I think our plays have just been getting better and better, and now that we have this new building, it's even better.
Through all of middle school, I played football, hockey, and lacrosse. Now I only play lacrosse because I focus fall and winter on theater. But the programs have always been amazing. I mean, back when I was in middle school, we had Kevin Pierre-Lewis and Silas Red, who were two of, like, the greatest athletes to ever go through King. And right now, Silas is at USC, and KPL is at Boston College. And Coach G was their coach, and he's still the coach of the football team today, and helps coach the lacrosse team. They're really, really great coaches, him and Coach Mack.
Mr. Bruno, he's really nice. He's a great coach. He breaks down the sport for me, makes it slows hockey down so I can more understand what he's trying to get us to do. And Mr. Lewis, he's hard. He's rough, but he's got a soft spot to him. And once you get to that, he's a really great guy to be around.
I play varsity field hockey and varsity softball. The athletic environment is very accepting. Anyone can come and try a sport, regardless of whether they've played before. And the coaches will help everyone try and improve throughout the season.
Coaches usually really push you hard. I mean, I play JV, so it's not, you know, as rigorous, but definitely they're very serious about winning and about, you know, maximizing your abilities as an athlete.
King is like, I mean, it's like the biggest community ever. I mean, obviously it's a small school, but everybody knows everybody. And I wouldn't say that there's ever a time when I say somebody's name or, like, I ask somebody a question or something like that, and they don't know who I am or I don't know who they are. Like, they don't at least recognize me or I don't recognize them. I'd say that for the most part, it's just like one big group of friends.
Because we have such small classes, the community is really small, which is good. And everyone gets to know each other and everyone's pretty much friends.
Everybody here at King is very, very friendly and very approachable, and they want to accept you into their circle of friends. So really you have nothing to worry about when it comes to making friends.
There we go. They did that with absolutely no input from any of us in the admission office. They also did it, you'll see various states of dress code and non-dress code. Part of this was filmed during Spirit Week before our homecoming, and that's where we had a number of different theme days, including Pajama Day and Spirit Day. So not always dress code in the video, but a great show of what the school is all about, and hopefully today you'll get an even greater sense of that, hearing more from our students and going on tours as well. So we have a jam-packed afternoon for you. For those of you who came in a little bit later, if you have not yet registered, please, on your way out, stop by either the laptops that we have set up or grab a piece of paper. This way we can hound you and make sure that you get the information that you need and set up times for schedules. Our admission office, our program for today, we've got a number of speakers coming in. We will then have a breakout session. So we will ask all of you who are interested in the upper school, grades 9 through 12, to leave us. And you'll be going on tours and going over to the upper school gym to meet with some of our faculty and department heads. Those of you interested in middle school, grades 6 through 8, we're going to ask you to remain here so you get to hear from the head of our middle school and our middle school speakers as well. So a lot going on this afternoon and some moving parts, but we're all here to help guide you through all of that. Our admission team, which you will meet coming through, and a few of us are in this building, I think, Meryl Schaefer is our assistant director of admission. She oversees our pre-kindergarten through grade 5. She is currently in the lower school, helping the lower school portion of the open house run. Mark Saraceno, our admission associate, is with our tour guides right now, and he works with 6th through 8th grade. And then Scott Carson, who I don't think, he's also with our tour guides at the moment. He'll be working with students in 9th through 12th grade. Catherine Lewis is our admission assistant. You will all be speaking to her anytime you pick up the phone and give us a call. Catherine is the one who makes all of our lives run so smoothly and getting all of our appointments scheduled, so you'll be chatting with her. And I would suggest that you give us a call as soon as you can to set up appointments. Our appointment times are filling up, and we want to make sure that everybody has an opportunity to come in. Parent appointments we'll schedule at any time. Student appointments we will schedule once we receive the first part of the application. We also invite you to follow us both on Facebook and on Twitter. It's a great way to see all that's happening on campus. As we were setting up for this event yesterday and making preparations, we were following Twitter to see how our soccer and our football teams were doing since we couldn't be at those games. So it's a great way to follow, learn a lot about what our faculty and what our students are doing. We also had some of our students who were highlighted in Mofley's 10 Teens to Watch. Paul Whittingham, who is our student council president and over here, who was highlighted in the video and will be one of our speakers. Paul was highlighted. Emma Snover, who is also in the corner, was highlighted, and Josh Ford was highlighted in Greenwich Magazine as well. In the interest of sustainability, we did not reprint this for you, but you can find it both on our website as well as in any of the publications. Little housekeeping. Application deadline. Part A of the application is due by December 16th. Again, I would encourage you all to get it in as soon as humanly possible. Part A is the easy part. It's your name and address and telephone number and all that good information. The parent statement and the student questionnaire, we have a little bit more time on that, but would encourage you to get this completed as soon as possible. For anybody who is interested in financial aid, SSS has opened November 1st, and they will be open and accepting applications through December 1st. So again, would encourage you to start that process now, because we do ask a lot of you, but it's so that we can get to know you better and you can get to know us better as we go through the process. I would now like to introduce to you our first speaker, Tom Main, our head of school.
Thank you all very much. That was a great video. I think that it's wonderful that we have that available, that you're able to go on tours with students, and that you'll hear from students soon, because I think it's really important for you to leave today, especially if it's your first experience with us, with a genuine understanding, or at least the beginning of a genuine understanding of what we're all about. Because independent schools are different. There are a lot of wonderful schools in this area. We are what we are, and so it's very important for us to try to give you an opportunity to understand that during this admission season, and in particular today. So I'm glad you're all here. As Carrie said, and as is clear, I'm Tom Main. I always enjoy speaking at this event each year, and I like doing so because I know education is all very, very important to you, so you're going to listen, and I enjoy that. It's also my sincere hope that this open house will help to demystify this process for you, especially if it's the first time you've been through it. Some of you have been through it before, but if you haven't been through it before, demystifying it a little bit, I think, is helpful. And I hope to give you, or the experience gives you, a strong sense of what I would say are the values and the strengths and the qualities of the institution, so that as you continue to think about independent schools for next year and beyond, you really have a sense of what we're all about. First and foremost, you should know that ours is a school of true educational excellence. We are challenging and we are demanding. Paul said in the video that, I wish I'd thought of this, but you need to bring your A game. That's a great line, right? And we don't all bring our A game every day, but the point is a good point. This is a challenging school, and we are going to demand the best of our students. We respect our students. And this respect leads us to expect much of them. I believe we're a school that values hard work, thoughtful reflection, intellectual sophistication at all of the developmental levels, and we're full, absolutely full, of capable, talented, accomplished, and ambitious students. So what makes us a special place? I'm going to comment on six specific qualities, and those of you that are good linear sequential thinkers will follow me as I tick through this. But I won't mention, but will in prefacing this list, the students. I mean, what really makes the school are the 700 students that come and live here every day, and we're very honored that 700 families, well, 570 families, because some families send a number of kids, will trust us with their children all day, all month, all year. We're quite honored, and they make us a very special place. But the place they come to has these qualities, I think, that create the context in which our kids grow up. First, the faculty. We really have a superb faculty. It's important to say that. I can't say that strongly enough. And they're what you would expect faculty members to be, in that they're experts in their fields. And they're real intellectuals, and they're extremely well-educated themselves. But as important, they are experts with kids and experts when it comes to learning. So it's not just physics, it's learning. It's not just mathematics, it's how do children learn. And even more important, they really love spending the day with kids. The most important qualifier when we're interviewing is, do you love kids? Are you going to enjoy spending all day with kids? Are you passionate about this career? Because if you're not, then it really doesn't matter, does it? If you're not, it really doesn't matter. And so we have wonderful teachers. They know their subjects. They are real experts with their subjects, with kids, but they are enjoying what they're doing. This is where they choose to be. Number two, we have small classes. Our average class size here is 10 to 15, a few classes having more, one or two more, a few having less. The class size is central to the success. Our teachers have the opportunity, because of the class size and reasonable class loads, to get to know each student, to meet their needs, and to demand the very best of them. Number three, a really superb academic program embedded in an approach to learning that is personalized. So we're a school for able and motivated students. As I said, we expect our students to work with a sense of purpose. Teachers challenge our students, demand their best. It's not a place where the process of learning is taken lightly. Within this context, this very demanding context, our faculty gets to know each student, their strengths, their challenges. We find methods and approaches that will enhance the learning process for each child. No student is the same, learns the same, expresses his or her knowledge the same, and we understand this. It's important that you understand this as you look at us. Number four, excellence in arts and athletics. Participation in these educational, arts and athletics or educational opportunities is critically important for so many of our students. We support and develop programs that are highly competitive and that represent the very best of the community values here at King. We are seeking to bring out the artist in your child, the actor, the athlete, the musician, and on, very important to what we do. Number five, the diversity in our community. We see diversity as much more than a set of demographic statistics. We see diversity as a condition of the excellence here, not a component. We see it as a core value. And I'm sure that I see this understanding as something that sets us apart from other schools in the area. And finally, number six, the culture at King. It's a culture that honors civility, thoughtful and open dialogue and respect, and it provides the foundation for the learning and the teaching that goes on here. Our mission statement clearly states, and this is a quote, King graduates are well equipped to succeed in college, pursue lives of ongoing inquiry, learning, accomplishment, personal fulfillment, and social responsibility, end quote. It's really the culture of the school that guides the pursuit of that mission ideal. I want to elaborate on what I think is the defining feature of our academic program, addressing the needs of each student. We talk about personalizing, which is a little different than individualizing. We talk about personalizing. What this means in a practical sense is that we are not a boilerplate school. There is no one approach that works for each grade or each section or each class or each student. Each student is a complex individual, a learner with strengths and weaknesses unique to him or her. So in practice, to bring this down to the micro, we must find a way to push the very strongest reader in the sixth grade while supporting the student who we can see is really capable but has no interest in picking up a book. We need to find a way to encourage that talented middle school student who lacks confidence in the classroom and on the field while creating leadership expectations that will stretch the most passionate athlete or the most gregarious English student in the upper school. We need to find a way to productively harness the enthusiasm and stress the value of collaboration upon the student who appears so interested she can't settle down and work effectively and benefit group work. And when faced with an exceptional math student who outruns the most challenging upper school math program before the end of their senior year, find a way to continue to push them to greater and higher successes in the formal study of mathematics. And the list goes on and on. For each student, there is a unique list. All of you parents, you have these lists in your head for your kids. Equally important to understanding what personalizing is in terms of our school is understanding what it is not. It is not changing expectations or requirements. In the high school, for example, pre-calc honors is pre-calc honors, as is USAP, United States Advanced Placement History, or French 3, or French 3 honors, or physics, or geometry, or AP Lit. The content and the demands are what they are in every strong and highly competitive school. We personalize by understanding each learner and guiding them as they engage in this demanding program in ways that take advantage of their cognitive strengths and talents, while helping to develop them in areas where they are experiencing challenge. This will always be a rigorous and a vigorous academic experience. Personalizing enables students to maximize their success and the development within that very, very demanding context. So at the end of a King education, at the end, what's the result? Most of the results are hard to quantify, and that's important to understand. Healthy and positive human development is not something that lends itself really easily to simple measurement. But it's something you feel, and you know it when you see it. You know it when people are developing the right way and growing up the right way. There are, of course, a couple places where we can measure things statistically, and we need to understand them as just that, the couple of places where you can measure things statistically, and they're worth sharing. In particular, our college placement here is very strong and getting stronger. There are well over 3,000 colleges and universities in the country, and we use the Barron's College Ranking system when we look at our numbers here. So there's a most competitive band, and there are generally 50 or 60 schools in that band. But each year, some schools move in and some schools move out. But of the well over 3,000, there are 50 or 60 that are in the most competitive band. And annually, 40 to 50% of our graduating seniors will go to those colleges. This band includes schools like Brown, Georgetown, UNC Chapel Hill, Haverford, Duke, Harvard, NYU, Tufts, Stanford, University of Chicago. Different sorts of schools, very different sorts of schools, but all in that particular band. Further, annually, another 35 to 45% of our seniors will go to the 100 or 110 or 120, because that's a band that moves a little bit, schools that are ranked as highly competitive colleges and universities. And this band includes schools like Skidmore, Villanova, Bucknell, Babson, Trinity College, Northeastern, Colorado College. Great schools, great schools. So each year, 85 to 90%, sometimes 95% going to those two bands. Often kids that are accepted into those bands going into a competitive school instead of a highly or a most, because it's the right match for them. Interestingly, and more important than the stats, I want you to pay close attention to this. Our students have gone through a process that focuses them on a search for a college that is right for them, that fits. So while the statistics are impressive, and we tend to look at those really quickly, the only important statistic for a student and his or her family is the quality of the match between the individual student and the college. So the only thing that's really important is when your son or daughter goes off to college, are they going to a place where they will continue to grow intellectually, socially, as a community citizen? Is it the right place for them? That's the most important thing. Our students have the confidence, I believe, and the self-awareness to find and choose a school that is right for them, and not just shop for names, which is a mindset that I believe too often dominates the entire college process. So there are three questions I think every parent should ask when thinking about our school. So I'm going to ask them, and then I'm going to answer them, and I hope you find that helpful. The first is, will my child be happy here? Will my child be happy here? And I think that's the most important question you can ask. And if you're anything like me as a parent, it's most likely your biggest worry. And the answer is yes. It's an incredibly happy school. It really is. The students enjoy their time here. The hallways are full of good cheer and energy and good humor. Teachers enjoy their students. Students enjoy the teachers. It's a place where the chances of feeling very good about yourself and very happy as you go through the day are really pretty high. Two, will my child be challenged here? And I think the answer to that is absolutely yes. We exist to challenge our students in the classroom and everywhere else. Great education is about taking risks, stretching oneself, sometimes succeeding, sometimes learning when we fall a little short. These challenges should take all sorts of shapes, and there are lots of different opportunities academically, artistically, athletically, in service learning, with leadership, in clubs and activities. In a small school, there's lots of access, there's lots of opportunity, and our students are encouraged to take full advantage and fully challenge themselves. And three, can I as a parent be involved in the life of the school? And the answer to that is clearly yes. Now, your children's answer may be different than that, but my answer is clearly yes. We'll ask you to be involved in a number of different ways. We want you to get to know your children's teachers, their advisors, their coaches, their drama coaches. We want you to help on committees with the PA on projects, with activities that interest you. We want you to attend games, be here for performances, be here for events. All that stuff is extremely important. And the better you get to know us, the more effectively we can team in support of your children. And we'll ask you to be involved with the school financially beyond tuition. We will do that. Like all independent schools, we have a yearly fundraising initiative that we call our annual fund, and it's critical to advancing our programs as aggressively as possible. We also conduct capital campaigns when the school has a specific capital need that will enhance our resources and the opportunities available to our students. The building we're in right now is a result of a capital campaign, and you heard students on the video talk about what an impact the building has had on their lives here at the school. So we encourage the entire community to be involved with these opportunities, and if you're here, we will ask you to do the same. So if you finish this process and arrive at King next fall for a 2 or a 3 or a 4 or a 5 or a 6 or a 7 year stint, what might you expect to have experienced when you graduate after those years? Here's what might come together over time and blend together into a meaningful education. Lots of classes that interest you, challenging enough to make you think hard and stretch your intellectual capacity. Teachers, people that are deeply committed to your success, people you will remember for the rest of your life. Opportunities everywhere, in athletics, in the arts, highly competitive opportunities if you want them, club activity opportunities if you want those. Community involvement, service learning programs that could include a trip to New Orleans to rebuild a home or participate in a midnight run to New York City. Diversity, opportunities to be far more aware of and understanding of different races and cultures and ethnicities and religions. Global awareness, you might have traveled with a school group to Greece or to Spain or to France or to Costa Rica or to China. We've had trips going every summer and during the course of the year. Leadership, in student government, our prefect system, team captainship, there are so many different leadership opportunities that are available to kids. And finally, friendship. And it's the last thing, but it may well be the most important. King graduates stay fast friends in a way that I have not experienced before in schools. It's really quite amazing. They stay connected a year after they graduate, 2 years after they graduate, 3 years after they graduate. Often there are 33 and 34 year old groups that are living together in a house out in Colorado because they all have jobs there, or a group of 24 year olds that are working in the city and sharing an apartment. But King graduates stay together in a way that really shows how deep the bonds are and how close the friendships are that are developed here. So thank you all for being here today. I think this is a wonderful place for children to grow up, and that's the way I look at it. It's just a wonderful place for children to grow up. My own children have and are growing up here, and I could not imagine them in a better place. I hope that the program today helps you to become more deeply aware, as I said in the beginning, of the character and the quality and then the sort of sense of purpose that resides here in our community. Because if you can grab that, if you don't know a lot about us, if you can grab that and leave here with that, that will be of great help to you as you go through this process and con- continue to look at us and also look at other schools. So thank you very much for your kind attention. Have a great day.
And now I'd like to introduce Marnie Sedleski, the head of our upper school.
On behalf of the entire upper school community, our faculty, our students, our staff, our parents, our administrators, welcome to King. And you have heard a lot of information thus far. You're holding information. Some of you are writing down pieces of information. You have had tours. You are going to yet go on tours. A lot of information. And, you know, this sort of an ironic moment for me as an educator and administrator, because at King, we do believe that human beings learn in so many variety of ways, and we've pretty much utilized two ways right now, right? We've spoken at you, and we've had you see a few visuals. But at King, we are a very dynamic place, and I know that some of you are probably not feeling very dynamic right now, so just, you know, try to, you know, give your shoulders a little twitch and your toes, there you go, toes a little squeeze in your shoes. And I am not going to give you a ton of information, because the kind of information that I can give you is really quite specific about academic programs, different concentrations. Maybe you have questions about our archaeology course. Maybe you have questions that are very specific to distinctions in global studies, distinctions in world languages, cross-divisional opportunities for leadership, et cetera, et cetera. I will be available in the upper school after this event, right near the front office. If any of you have specific questions, I can either guide you to the right person, like an academic dean, a chair of the math department, et cetera, some coaches if you have questions about athletics, or just to simply invite you to come back and to visit and to probe a little bit more deeply. So this is an open invitation to come see me. I'll direct you to others who can help you, and also at any time, please, please do come back, make appointments, come back, ask every question you have. This is an incredibly important decision. Without further ado, I would like to introduce the head of our student body, the president of our student body. But before I do that, I want to say that these folks who are standing, wave, students, wave. You got to wake up too, right? These guys are the reason that we do what we do here at King. This is my 17th year at King. I've taught in several divisions and served the school in different capacities. And the deep passion that my colleagues have for the field of education, and the wonderful students we work with here are the reason that I am here. So, Mr. Whittingham, please join us, and he will give you an example of what we ask all of our students to do in the middle school and in the high school, and that is take on roles, take on challenges, take on leadership positions, and not everyone becomes head of a student body, but we are going to start with that particular role, and he will introduce, I think, or Ms. Salvatore will introduce after he's done, the rest of the students who will speak about their time at King and the roles they've played, okay? Welcome to King. I'll be in the upper school after this is over.
So, good afternoon, parents and prospective students. We're pleased to welcome you all to King, and we cannot wait to show you around our wonderful campus. King is a very rigorous and challenging school, as I said before. We have academics, athletics, and arts. A prospective King student must be prepared to work hard. That being said, it is even more difficult to fail here at King. Our wonderful teachers, whether they are coaching a game or teaching a class, are always available to aid students in any way possible. The King community consists of a variety of talented individuals in the arts. From the plays, to the musicals, to our clay and painting classes, we showcase our talents to the broader community. For example, the art department last year allowed King students to participate in the 1 Million Bones project that raised awareness about ending genocide around the world. Additionally, we have a wonderful athletic program. Sorry, I'm losing my spot here. That consists of both varsity and junior varsity teams. I personally play tennis in the fall, and I enjoy traveling to Florida over spring break for spring training in order to bond with my teammates. Finally, we have some of the best
teachers available here to our students. For example, I was struggling in physics this past week, and my physics teacher, Dr. Williams, stayed until 6 p.m. in the evening to help me and another student better understand the concepts we were going over in class. Our teachers will go the extra mile to provide a solid foundation for us. What makes a good King student, one may ask? The answer is simple. A King student is a naturally curious individual who is able to network, self-advocate, and establish a strong self-discipline. This does not come to every student immediately, but like Clay, the support system at this school, such as the advisors who are assigned to about 10 students each, will help guide students to create good habits and goals. I'm Paul Whittingham, and I currently operate as one of the captains of the tour guide team, as well as the president of the upper school body, among other things. I'm here because of the support and guidance given to me by the faculty here at King, and it is an honor to be able to speak in front of the future generation of King students and parents. Thank you so much, and I wish you all a wonderful day.
And I wonder why we have the adults up here at all. Thank you, Paul, very much. I would like the rest of our student speakers to please come up. And as they get settled, we have a mix of freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors, and some students who have only been with us for a month, and some students who have been with us for quite a long time. So I will now actually start as soon as Claire gets settled. I'm going to ask Claire to start at that end and to introduce yourself, how long you've been at King, and where you came from.
I'm Claire. This is my first year at King, and I went to a public school, Fox Lane.
I'm Richard, and this is my first year at King as well, and I went to Eastern Middle School in Greenwich.
Hi, I'm Laurel, and this is my second year at King. And before that, I went to New Canaan Country School.
Hi, I'm Chelsea. This is my third year at King, and I went to Uncle School in Fairfield.
Hi, my name is Kate. This is my first year at King.
Hi, my name's Tom. It's my third year, and I went to Eastern Middle School as well.
Hi, my name is Alex Britton. I came here in fifth grade, and I'm from Oxford School in Darien.
Hi, I'm Paul. I've been at King since sixth grade, and thank you all for being here.
And Paul, I'm going to start with you. These are the questions that I ask every year of these students. You think by now they would know exactly what I'm asking. But I'd like you to talk about what your favorite thing at King is.
Man.
You can say what you said in the video as well.
I think definitely my favorite thing personally is the support. And you get to learn how to be a self-advocate. And I really think that's an important part of growing up and being able to interact with, I guess, whoever you come across and being able to kind of adjust to different scenarios. So I think my favorite thing about King is definitely how they teach you to be a self-advocate.
My favorite thing at King would probably have to be the teachers that relentlessly work by your side to get you to where you need to be. Not just academically, it's just out of the classroom as well. For example, my history teacher has also been very an integral role in a service trip that I've done for the past 2 years now, going down to New Orleans and being a part of that. Or my math teacher has been an integral part outside of the classroom as well in terms of going and playing golf on a spring trip, or, you know, everybody is involved other than, you know, just academics, which is really, really awesome.
Yeah, I agree with what Alex said. I'll say something different. Definitely the friends that I have at King, it's great. Monday mornings aren't always great, but you know, I actually do enjoy coming to school. Get to see like all my friends. I enjoy having free periods when I can kind of relax, talk to them. So yeah, definitely friends. I made friends right away. It's, everyone supports you, everyone welcomes you. So yeah, it's great.
So I'm a new student here at King, and I have to say that the community is just unbelievable. I came from New Canaan Country School, and after being there for 12 years, I know a lot of people here may have been at their schools for a really long time, and the thought of going to another school is just crazy to them. And I went on a student diversity leadership conference, and I met people there from King, actually, and that's how I got involved in, you know, this school and everything. And after meeting them, I just knew right away that these people were so kind and just welcoming. And when I came here, it, you know, you could just tell that from the teachers and everyone else. So my favorite part is definitely the community.
I would also agree with the community, but also athletics. I'm very athletic and into athletics, so I would say the support of just all the students and faculty. You're never going to have an empty crowd. Maybe just a few people, but they're always cheering you on and they're by your side.
Just going off of the community again, I think it's really great whether you do athletics or you're in the musical art program, that both the teachers and the student body really want to see what you're doing or what you're interested in. And it's really fun to either look out to the crowd or look out to the bleachers and see your math teacher or see your friends cheering you on.
My favorite thing about King is how welcoming everyone is to you. Even being a new student here, you walk in and you go on either a school trip or you do preseason if you do a fall sport, which really helps to introduce you to new people, as well as people who've been here for a long time.
I agree with like everyone else on the community. but another thing I like about King is, I know before they were saying that it's very challenging, and to me, I would kind of think that as like scary, but it actually really helps, and it helps you succeed. If there's not someone pushing you to do better, then you're not going to do better. So.
Awesome. Thank you. And in the interest of time, I'm going to ask just one last question. What is one thing you don't like or you would like to see us change? And this is why I ask. Because they can't think of anything. And this is why we ask this question. And we will often ask students this. If you've gone on tour, Mr. Carson or some of your tour guides will stop students and ask them. I know Alex has an idea, I'm sure. Anyone would like to share? Anything? Go ahead, Alex. There's one in front of you. Grab the other mic. Alex, grab the other microphone. There you go.
There we go. You know, like, honestly, like, I've had some time to think about this question, so this wouldn't have come that easily to me, but the one thing that I don't really like about King, and it's not really a big deal, is the email system at this school. I don't really like it.
I agree with that. from the... I went to boarding school freshman year, and we used Outlook as our email. I thought that was a little bit easier, but that's other than that, like, I really can't think of anything. So it's great. We enjoy it. We enjoy coming here. Yeah.
Excellent. Anyone else? All right. And finally, if one or two of you could just, any piece of advice that you would like to give the prospective families and students that are out there about what they should look for at King.
I'd say just take advantage of every opportunity that's thrown at you at this school. As far as like the students in this audience go, like your parents are making a good decision bringing you guys to this information session. I honestly think that coming to this school was probably one of the best things that's ever happened in my growth as a human in general. You know, it's a place where I've been able to grow up and take advantage of things that I normally would not have been able to take advantage of in a public school setting or really any other private school around. So just taking advantage of every opportunity.
Basically, I guess in looking at King, I would really recommend that you ask the hard questions or the questions that are just like, you know, why would you ask that question kind of thing? You know, honestly, you're going to get the best sense of King through the students, and that's no offense to any of the faculty here, but you're going to get the authentic experience at King from the students if you come talk to us, because everybody here is basically approachable and very open to being very honest with you. So don't be afraid to ask the questions that you like, is that appropriate or not? Ask them, because we will answer your questions.
Excellent. Tom?
Yeah, going off what Paul said, everybody here is like here to help you grow up as an individual. If there's anything you ever need help with, you can literally ask anybody. Anybody will help you. I know I can ask my teachers anything that I need help with, anything I need help with, anything I'm not sure about. They'll always be there to help you. Definitely reach out. Reaching out always helps.
And then just one last thing, I think definitely be open to trying new things, whether it's a different learning style, different teachers have different approaches, or trying a new club or a different trip to go on. Definitely be open to trying new things and definitely try them.
I would say take advantage of everything you have. I'm really grateful to be here at this school. I know that I'm getting a good education and I'm going to succeed in life.
Excellent. And I think we will end on that note. Before we break out for tours and then the middle school session, I do just want to share this with you. Earlier this week, I sent out an e-notify on that email system they don't like. I sent out an email to our parents to update everyone on what was happening in the admission office, to talk about today's events, to talk about our new pre-kindergarten structure, and to talk about last year's record-breaking admission season. Last year, we had an acceptance rate of just 30% with an overall yield of almost 80%. And with our lowest attrition ever of just 5%. This year, and that actually was just an amazing year for an extraordinarily strong school. This year, we are setting a record-breaking pace again. As of today, we have double the number of applications we did at this time last year. And last year was double the number of the year before. Please do not let that panic you. There is plenty of room. There is plenty of opportunities for everybody. But don't let that set you into a panic, okay? We want everybody's application to come in and everybody have an opportunity to come and visit with us. But when I sent out this email, I received a response from a parent that I do want to share with you, because I was just so overwhelmed by her response. And this is one of those emails that we always keep in a happy folder on those really crazy days. It said, wow, from your email below, it looks like another very busy, exciting and busy admission year ahead. King is a great school, so it comes as no surprise that you've already got them knocking on your door even before open house. My son has already been enlisted to be a tour guide as a brand new student and will be there to help out in full formal attire. Which brings me to my next point, sharing his transition to King with you. I'm sure you must like to hear all your newbies do once they pass from your doors into the classrooms. He is really, really happy, and I can barely tear him away from wall ball or football on the lawn to get him in the car at the end of the day. He seems to have made friends very quickly. He loves his classes and teachers and can't figure out why time passes just so quickly when he's at school. Although he's far from mastering the art of time management with the additional jump in homework, he is working hard and bringing in some very nice grades. He joined the football team, and after 4 years of playing tackle football here in town, he scored his very first touchdown the other day under the awesome coaching of Mark McAndrews and a supportive group of fellow players. You can only imagine what this has done for his self-confidence and enthusiasm for future King sports teams. He was also very excited to be asked by admission to help out this weekend and is looking forward to showing prospective students around what he can now proudly call his school. And now for the icing on the cake. He has immersed himself in King community and ran for class representative. To his surprise, he won. But most importantly are the following words that he put in his campaign speech, which he did entirely on his own. You may be wondering why there's a new kid running for class representative. Well, that's because all of you have given me so much by helping me fit in. You feel comfortable, and you've gone out of your way to help me have a great transition to a new school. It says a lot that I'm new and running for class representative on the actual first full week of school. That proves you must be pretty good people to help someone feel so comfortable here so fast. Need I say more? His words speak for themselves. We know he's in the right place and cannot thank you enough for considering him. Meanwhile, the moms I've met are truly great people. Their enthusiasm is infectious, which is why I found myself signing up for the fundraiser, midnight run, snack stand, uniform exchange, and finally, you must brace yourself. As a member of the Green Committee, you may spot me weeding in the vegetable garden. So all is good, he is settled in very nicely, and I can only wish that next year's incoming students have as great an experience. So we all hope that you will have similar experiences today. I encourage you to start the application process again as soon as possible. As the students have mentioned, I encourage you to ask a lot of questions. We will have all of our students and faculty available for you. Now, for those of you who are here for upper school, grades 9 through 10, we would ask that you now leave us. And you're going to exit out that way to go to the breakout sessions in the upper school. Middle school, you can stay where you are. Nicely done.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nicely done.
So first and foremost, good afternoon, everyone. As the screen said, Ms. Salvatore said, I'm Bobby Walker Jr., the head of middle school here at King, and I'm excited that I'm entering my ninth year here. After moving up from Baltimore in 2005, I can tell you right now that this is one incredible place. I've always wondered if I could be inside of all your heads right now, wondering what brings you out to open house today. Maybe you've heard of King from a family friend or a neighbor. Or perhaps you saw one of our ads in a local newspaper, or maybe even have someone, a current relative, or someone who attends here. But regardless of what brought you here today, I can assure you of a few facts that you need to know so that when you leave here, you'll be fully aware of what a King Middle School education can bring. So whether this is your first open house or one of many, I can promise you that you'll find King to be a very unique school in the greater Fairfield County, Westchester County area. So, like a lot of schools, I'm sure if you've heard their spiel, everyone talks about academic excellence in describing their program. Here at King, we also seek to push our students to thrive in a rigorous academic program. So whether you're taking advanced classes in math or science or foreign languages, whether it's through performance on standardized tests or in national, regional, or local competitions, I'm always proud of our middle school students and how they perform. Our faculty members consistently work together to create a curriculum that is innovative, collaborative, and always helping our students prepare for their futures as well-educated, well-rounded, productive citizens of their communities. So the King faculty has fully dedicated themselves to being absolute difference makers in the world of their students, consistently attending workshops and seminars on best practices in education. The middle school faculty strives to be area leaders on the methods that we use to teach our students. Members of this faculty attend professional growth and development opportunities around the country to bring back research-proven techniques to their classrooms and to share with others in team meetings. But looking at our curriculum always answers what we teach. Our commitment to professional growth and development pushes us to answer how we teach. However, I feel that the difference that a King education makes in a child's life is our dedication to whom we teach. I don't believe, and this is my third school where I've worked, that any school where I've been absolutely focuses on students the way we do here at King. You've heard from everyone about how we personalize, and the depth at which we get to know our students is absolutely unparalleled, whether I was in Dallas, in Baltimore, or even at other area schools. So at King, your child is always going to be much more than a series of grades, test results, or athletic averages and wins. We recognize them as individuals, individuals who deserve the very best of all of our efforts. So this is the difference that a King education makes. When I first met Mr. Main back in January of 2005, he sold me on coming to King because it was the only place that I interviewed that year where the sole commitment and the absolute focus on each individual student was the school's hallmark. Not talking about test grades or anything, Mr. Main talked about how we were committed to helping each student be as successful he or she could be, and that's the reason I'm here 9 years later. And I promise you that once you leave today, you'll see that that commitment is real and that our students thrive. With that said, I'm going to reintroduce Ms. Salvatore, who's going to really give you guys a taste of the middle school experts. I read a speech, those guys know everything. But I will be around right after this, able to answer any questions. I'll be standing here in the PAC lobby, but I'll also be in the middle school for those of you who've already been on tours if you have questions, and I'll also remain afterwards if I can answer any very specific concerns or questions or anything that I can. And for all the students out there, remember, the best questions come from you guys. So don't be afraid to speak up today and speak out and ask them anything. You guys ready? So with that, I'm gonna turn it over to our middle school panel. Thank you all so much for coming, and I can't wait to see you a little later.
And now, our esteemed middle school panel. So beginning with Darren, yes, all your names are up there. Darren, I would like you to begin by introducing yourself. Tell how long you have been at King and what your favorite thing is about King. Grab the microphone.
Darren, pull the mic right out of it.
All right.
Thank you.
So, hi, my name is De'Aaron Carson. This is my fourth year at King. I'm in eighth grade, and my favorite thing about King is how diverse the school is and how we have like different ethnicities coming, so we're not all just one simple ethnicity or race. We're a whole color or kaleidoscope of race, color, and ethnicity.
Hello, my name is Alex Knorr, and I'm in King, seventh grade, and my favorite thing about King is the athletics, because I love athletics, and I might not get the opportunities that I would in normal school, so I just love the sports at King.
Hi, I'm Amanda Hall. I've been at King for 7 years. I'm in the sixth grade, and my favorite part about King is the individuality.
Hi, my name is Ben Castle. I have been at King for 1 year. I'm in sixth grade. And my favorite thing about King is that the classes aren't too big, so you get a lot of one-on-one time with the teacher, and they're always there for you.
Hi, I'm Tommy Morris. This is my first year at King. I'm in sixth grade. My favorite thing about King is the revolving schedule, because you don't have to be at the same place every day at the same time.
Hi, my name is Jamie. I'm in the eighth grade. This is my third year here, and my favorite thing is the community. We're all very different, but like they said, the class size is really small, so everyone really gets to know each other, so I think that's really great.
And I'm gonna ask you guys the same thing I asked the upper school. What's one thing you don't like about King or that you'd like to change? Jamie! Anybody?
What I think we could change at King is that in the lunch line, they like run through the middle, but I feel like they could like split up to the sides, so like there's not like one huge line in the middle.
I'm blank.
I can't really change anything really about King. Well, what Ben said about the lunch line and how we could have at least, and one thing I would love to change about King is how the upper school has dress down day on the last Friday of each month. That's right, Mr. Walker, I'm talking right to you. That's one thing I would like to change, how we could have to do the same thing as the upper schoolers.
Not bad if lunch line and dress card are the only two things that I think we're in pretty good shape. And lastly, what would be a little bit of advice that you would give people who are looking?
Okay. Yeah, it goes back to you. My advice is be organized, because they really do push you here, so it's always great to stay on top of things.
My advice would be to not be shy in the first day and make a lot of friends.
My advice would be memorize your schedule so you don't get mixed up on all of your classes.
My advice would be to be open to everything, because there are a lot of choices in the middle school, and be open to all ideas that people give you.
My advice would be to be nice, work hard, and ask questions.
My advice for incoming King student is that don't be afraid to ask your teacher or ask her any help. And I'm sort of learning this skill myself as I go along at King. So don't be afraid to go to a teacher and ask for help. Since it is a small class, you'll have one-on-one time with the teacher.
Excellent. And now, since you all have been sitting for so long, we're going to break out now for additional tours if you have not yet taken a tour of the middle school. And then we also have in our middle school commons departments and teachers who have broken out. So if you've had a tour, but you'd like to learn a little bit more about the middle school science program or the middle school sports program, our faculty are available there for you. Again, thank you all so much for coming out and enjoying this day, and we look forward to seeing you all soon. Thank you.